Good evening! We're going to be cooking seafood chowder today. A recipe from Louisiana in the USA. For that you'll need 500 grams of Mariana mix. As you can see, there's red fish, white fish, which is snapper and barramundi respectively. You can also see some prawns within the Mariana mix. And there's also scallops. Any ordinary fish store, you can get the Mariana mix even from the supermarkets. Next ingredient is carrots. About 1 to 2 carrots, finely chopped, bite-sized pieces. B-I-T-E, bite-sized pieces. Next is celery stick, finely chopped, 1 piece to 2 pieces. Next are the sweet potatoes, about 1 sweet potato neatly chopped into bite-sized pieces. Next are about a couple of corn cobs. Remove all the corn this way. You also get corn sold separately in tiny little tins on supermarkets, that's also acceptable. Next is the chicken stock. This you have to dissolve 1 or 2 cubes into boiling water and you get your chicken stock, about 1 cup of it. Next is around 200 mils, don't need 300 mils, but I'll use 300 for this recipe, of thickened cream. Next ingredient are the chives. Need about 2 tablespoons of chives and about 2 tablespoons of fresh parsley. And obviously nothing can be cooked without salt and pepper, but I like to use sea salt for all my cooking. And let's get chowdered with this seafood chowder recipe. The second step is in a ordinary cooking stove. Add some carrot first up, there's no need of oil. Here comes the celery. Celery second into it. Third are the sweet potatoes. And then to this, I've dissolved a couple of soup cubes into some 1 cup of boiling water. That's the stock. The stock goes into this, and all this should be boiled for a total of 10 minutes. So now we'll do the boiling for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes of heating, the carrots, the celery, the sweet potatoes in the chicken stock, it should be relatively soft. This is when we switch off the heating, and all this mixture should be transferred into a food processor. This is an average food processor, and the food processor will process all the food and make it extremely thin. I'm going to add all this into the food processor. It's got 2 very sharp blades, as you can see in it. Now, because I'm filming and also have to do the documentary, I think it's better I do it in separate steps. So I will, after ceasing the recording, add all this stuff into the food processor and then process it for about 5 or 10 minutes, maybe at the most 5 minutes, until it's extremely soft. And then we'll resume with the recording for the next step. And here is the mixture from the pan about to be processed in the food processor. Marginally soft, I'll just keep going intermittently for the next 5 minutes until it's completely soft. Here are the dials. And that looks quite soft. And so I will take this and put it back into the pan for the next step. And this is how the processed mixture should appear from the food processor before we return it back to the pan for the next step, during which the corn kernels will be added and more of the cooking takes place. The next step is to add the corn kernels into this mixture which I've just taken out of the food processor. Mix them in all together. And you need to simmer it for approximately another 10 minutes until the corn is tender. After that, that's the next step. After that, we will be adding in the Mariana mix. Welcome back. This is after heating the mixture that was recently food processed with the corn kernels. One little tip about corn kernels, I purchase ordinary corn kernels. I never purchase sweet corn, because there's also some talk about sweet corn kernels causing cancer. So I just avoid sweet corn. This is just ordinary corn cobs with the corn taken out of it. Once the corn is a bit soft, to this you can now add the Mariana mixture. And let it all boil together for about 3 to 5 minutes. And at this stage you can also add the salt and pepper into it and mix them all together. Now you can see that the seafood is almost fully cooked. The corn kernels are soft. Here's a scallop, almost fully cooked. Here's some fish, almost fully cooked. Here's a prawn, rolled up by now, almost fully cooked. It's just 5 minutes of boiling the seafood inside the mixture. At this stage, you can get rid of the heat because it's fully cooked, and we're going to add in the thickened cream. About 200 to 300 mils of it can be added straight up. And now it's actually done. If you prefer, you can add salt if you want more saltier taste to it. But the seafood has done two things. The actual fish and scallop and prawns have their own moisture, and that's why the moisture content appears increased. That's because of the endogenous moisture content within the seafood itself, which is added to this. On top of this, you can add chives and parsley, about 1 to 2 teaspoons each, depending on how much taste you like. And obviously sea salt can be added to make it more tastier. But seafood itself, that's the second point, seafood itself has a lot of salt, which will make it taste saltier. And to serve it, it's basically a chowder, C-H-O-W-D-E-R, which is basically a form of a soup. So you need to serve it with bread, so you can add crusty bread into it, the type of crusty bread you would as a base for things like bruschetta. But in my case, I like to eat paleo food, so this is the bread I usually eat every morning, 2 slices before I come to work, wholemeal and seeds, low GI, high in fiber. I usually eat 2 slices of this bread along with this food. Here's a close-up view of the chowder in a serving dish. What's really good about the taste is you can actually taste the carrots, you can actually taste the sweet potato flavor along with the corn, which grinds in your teeth, and then there's seafood to chew between. Here's a sample piece. You can have a look at it. That's why it's thickened. It's the carrots and the sweet potato and the celery. On top of that, it's got that corn on it. I want to take a piece with some seafood in it. Here's a piece of, looks to me like fish, and I'm going to taste it now. Very tasty. Highly recommend you make this for the summer. Seafood chowder. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Until we meet next time, this is how to spend a boring Sunday evening. Cook something nice to liven up your spirits
and good night.